Our playoff march is slowly dragging as the Toronto Maple Leafs lose 5-4 in overtime to the New Jersey Devils. Our playoff match continues tonight as the North Coast is taking on the Tigers. And the Leafs are rocking it out in the Music City. Oh man, that was great. Sorry about the bedhead, guys, but this video was made about an hour before Leafs lunch started on Saturday, and I'm actually on my way out for the weekend, but should be back Sunday morning in time to actually make my way down to Rioch Coliseum to partake in the private box event that is being hosted by Leafs Space member Chancellor. Now on to the game. A couple of players in New Jersey got their very first NHL career goals last night. For the Leafs, it was Carl Gunnarson who guns his first goal in 6 minutes into the first period, which actually got deflected and went top shelf left side, in which Martin Brodeur, as great of a goalie as he is, was not able to stop. And then, less than a minute later, Zach Parise ties the game and then breaks the tie with scoring 2 goals in the first period, and Zubris makes it 3-1 New Jersey as the first period ends. And in the second period, Jonas Gustafsson was pulled in favor of Vesa Toskala, mainly because the New Jersey Devils were putting the pressure on Toronto and they weren't getting anything done in the second period, so I guess that's Ron Wilson's way of saying, wake up guys, play better! And they do. In fact, Colton Knorr scores the second goal for the Toronto Maple Leafs in the second period on a breakaway that is actually more of a goal scorer's goal. Interesting enough, because he's actually an enforcer. But, you know, whoever scores for the Leafs, I guess it doesn't really matter as long as the goals count. And also in the second period, Patrick Davis gets his very first NHL career goal, which happens to be as a member of the New Jersey Devils, sending the game into the third period with a score of 4-2 for New Jersey. But the Pony Express delivers another goal, bringing Toronto within one, and Matt Stajan scores his 16th goal of the season, which also happens to tie his career-high goals for season of 16, so obviously, even though a lot of Leaf players are not doing as great as they're supposed to be, Matt Stajan pretty much is doing better than a lot of people expected. In fact, I think despite where the Leafs are this year, he is having his best career season of his career. So, but yeah, the game did go into overtime. And Travis Sajak, oh god, I was watching Wheel of Fortune again. Travis Sajak sort of broke the tie, and I don't know. To me, that looked like goaltender interference, but who am I to argue the refs? I mean, I'm just a spectator who watches from my couch, so it's not like I can go down to New Jersey and prove them wrong. But either way, the Toronto Maple Leafs do come away with a point, but we need to start getting 2 points a game to make it to the playoffs, because Burke's not happy with this. Jamal Mayers and Garnet Exelby want out of the Toronto Maple Leafs, mostly because they're not getting enough play time. But with Garnet Exelby, I'm sort of on the fence about that, because I think he could have done... He's not that great of a defensive player, but he is a good physical defensive player, but he doesn't always cover his assigned guys, so I don't know who we're going to get for him. As for Jamal Mayers, we'll probably get the same kind of draft pick that we traded away to get him with, so I don't know. But I also wanted to point out another thing about the game. Zach Parise, I think, was a bit overconfident and trying too hard to get that hat trick. I mean, Jersey would have won if he did get it, but, you know, when you focus on that instead of winning the game, you know, it just doesn't happen. I mean, players don't really care about getting hat tricks. It's all about winning the game. Like, just do your best, do great passings, and if the opportunity comes up, then take it. Just don't get a little overconfident, and, you know, the goals will come. And this is a message that I think all the Leaf players should do. I mean, Phil Kessel gets covered a lot, but, you know, that's where he becomes a great passer. I mean, the shooting lanes are taken away from him, so he has been passing very good to help other Leaf players get their goals and get better chances. Although, the only thing I don't understand, even though we get a lot of shots per game, why aren't they good quality shots? Like, a lot of Leaf players, they're just shooting at the net hoping that they're going in. So, my question is, Ron Wilson, what do you guys have to do to actually get the Leaf players to get better quality shots on net that actually turn to goals, like top shelves that don't miss, side shots that don't go to the side of the net or hit the post? What do the Leafs have to do to improve so that they can actually become a playoff team, make the playoffs, and become the 2010 Stanley Cup champions, like I keep assuming that they are, even though I'm pretty much going to call them the 2010 Stanley Cup champions in my videos, only because I'm a very passionate Leaf fan, and I have high expectations. So if you guys are going to insult me because I'm calling them the 2010 Stanley Cup champions, that's why. So, I don't know when I'll make my next video, whether it's going to be Sunday morning before going to the Marlies game, or if it's coming back from the Marlies game and actually talking about that game itself and what exactly went on in that event. So, who knows? Maybe I'll even run into Brian Burke again. anyhow, until sometime Sunday, go Leafs, go!